Yo, what's up, chat? So, let me add my camera to this scene. If my camera doesn't add, then we shall be okay. I can deal without it. There it goes. Let's see, where do we put this? Probably bottom right seems okay. All right, so we are starting our adventure through Temtem. We're gonna try this game out. See how it goes. We just went through character creation. I heard that there was like some issues with like making character creation and stuff like that. So wanted to go through that really quick, and hopefully there's been some issues with the game so far, but just normal, I think, in my opinion, MMO type of stuff that usually happens, like loading and stuff like that. I don't think there's really much you can do about that, to be honest. So it is what it is, basically. We have already done the alpha stress test, so we got like halfway through the first route. I know this is a big day for you, but we're also gonna miss you. A little pocket money for trip. Not so much, but we all chipped in. And Max is gonna destroy me. One day they're gone, don't worry. Drop them off at the academy. So we kind of had our thoughts about this game already, or whatever. And kind of the appeal of it, or whatever. I think there's some good, and I think there's some bad with this game. But it's definitely something that we'll check out and try out and give like a acceptable try to, for sure. Time to choose our Temtem. I do like that it's on Steam or whatever. Got digital Temtem. Did you get that? Go ahead. See which one you will take. I'm gonna get the crystal one, I think, this time around. We chose a psychic one in alpha testing, so let's try this one. We gotta move on, kids. You hit tab, that's where you can see all our stuff. You can see details about it or whatever. Right, go here, you go to squad. And check out your Temtem there. First staged fight with Max. Mechanical heat, it's gonna one hit kill me probably. Oh, almost. What's this do? Knocks me out. This is the staged fight or whatever it is. This is like blah blah blah. He gives you the second Temtem, which is the birdie. I'm curious to see if you already have one, not fair, blah blah blah. Okay, we have to just start heading out. We get the Tem cards too. We got the heals. I wanna see if we're able to heal back at home or anything like that, because we never checked that out on the first one. And since this isn't the stress test, we can take a little bit more time. Oh, you're back. Let me take care of your time. Okay, so she does heal you. That's cool. Yeah, but since this is not the stress test and this is the actual game, we can kind of take our time and like, congratulations, princess. Looking for Pepe. He was supposed to help me with lunch, but he must have scurried off to catch Temtem with that husband on him. Have a great time at the county. See you. She goes. So, yeah, it's one of those things where we don't really have to worry about running around and, like, rushing through it right now. So I do want to take my time a little bit and, like, talk to people. and see like everything that's going on and what there's to do. It is kind of funny that it's kind of an MMO and there's like all these people around that they can see me, I can see them, and yet like the interaction is just so weird. So I guess this is where you look up trainer IDs. We all have unique IDs. I don't think any of my friends are on here. You can interact with anyone who's within the same instanced area as you as well, which is kind of cool. Hey, is it true you're going to Academy? Yeah, Max is coming too. Max is a friend. Well, you know, something you just wanted to see you. Whatever. It's jelly. But yeah, so it is kind of weird that like we can all just run in here and there's this like like kind of harass the people that are around here, you know, in a sense, and just kind of like invade their privacy. And it's like you go into a house, there's like 50 people or whatever. Temtem God, what up, Jeremy? How's it going? I'm in Discord too. If you wanna chat. So one of the things that I've already noticed with this game is the people around is just really weird. That's something that I definitely have to get used to. The game definitely feels like a harder version of Pokemon. I don't know if harder is the right way to say it. Some people would say it's more tedious as well. But you can't just like talk to somebody. Like, so there's a lot of back and forth dialogue with almost everyone that you talk to or whatever. Remember this one. One day you'll learn to appreciate the simple things. So there's a lot of back and forth dialogue that happens when you talk to people, which seems to happen a lot in this game, which is fine. It's just something to get used to. There's also a lot of side quests, but there's no tracking. So, the map's pretty huge as well. This is the first island. I don't know how many more islands there are to this game, but apparently there's like 6 or 7 islands, and each island has specific Temtems to them. So, I think this island is mostly like bug and air duders or something like that. All these people are flying for PvP, so if I wanted to, I could fight them. One of the things I did notice when playing this game is that there's not a lot of Pokestops. So this is the first route. This is route 1. And one of the things I noticed in the alpha test was that, and I don't know if it's changed, but potions are really, really expensive and almost needed, in my opinion, in this game. So if you didn't know, the game is double battles as well. Your Temtems don't have PP, but they use this thing called stamina, which you can see here. And the stamina goes down every single turn. So there's that. You can rest or switch out your Pokemon. So if you rest, your Pokemon won't attack. But what will happen is it will recharge its stamina a little bit. When a Temtem's stamina gets below, I believe, 50% health, the attacks do half damage. And when it's at 0, your Temtem will start taking damage. So there is that as well. This is kind of how you catch a Temtem. They're called Tem cards. You get their traits. You get their, these are their IVs, 1 through 50. 50 is the best, basically. You can decide to squat it or release it. And there's no XP share in this game as well, guys. So keep that in mind. That there is no XP share, so you will have to switch out your Temtems and stuff like that to get stuff. It's pretty simple, though. Just click and drag to switch out stuff. It's not that bad. Encounter rates seem really weird, too. Like, I'll be running around in a brush for, like, a really long time. sometimes you walk in like this, and it's, like, an instant brush thing. So I don't really know. There are, like, Pokestops and stuff like that. But Nothing too crazy. Red means it's gonna do half damage, but I don't really care. So we should be able to knock this out right now. The Temtem battles can either be a 2v1 like this or a 2v2 in wild. In battles, I believe they're only 2v2. So let me know how the volume is. I turned it way down because I was just tired of listening to the music, but the game definitely feels, in my opinion, MMO-esque too. So what I mean by that is that from, I guess this is like a very minor complaint for me, but for me, the game cannot be rushed through. It seems like it takes a very long time to get through the game. As you can see here too, from what I've been told, your Temtems are very weak until they evolve. Especially the starters are very poor. Like that was like 2 level 2s. I'm already knocked out, whereas in Pokemon it probably wouldn't do something like that, which is kind of interesting. So that's kind of one of the problems for me, is I don't like to use items. So for me, it's probably going to take me even like longer to get through this game. A couple other things to keep note of, when it comes to Temtem leveling, your Pokemon will evolve a certain amount of levels from when you obtain them. So that's something big to keep in mind. So for example, if we look at my squad right now, Crystal evolves 30 levels from when you obtain them. All the starters, by the way, are able to be caught as well in this game, so you're not limited. But yeah, so Crystal, for example, will evolve at level 35. Now, let's say we obtain a Crystal at level 20. It will not evolve at level 35, it will evolve at level 50. So that's something to keep in mind too, as well. That's how evolution works in this game, and they did that, they said, to make it so that you can't just buy, like, actually capturing really strong Temtems is actually, like, at a disadvantage, right? Like, higher level Temtems, because they may never evolve, because they'll have multiple Evo stages as well. I don't know what this thing is, but I want to capture it. It's really weak, though. But we'll have to see. I like it, whatever it is. I'm gonna try to catch it. It's like a weird bunny thing. So it's a neutral Temtem, so it's normal type. Has something called resilience, cannot be knocked out due to overexertion, which basically means it can't damage itself when it loses like PP or whatever, which is kind of cool. Alright, let's move on. But these over here, this too is a loot box, so that's something that we got to keep in mind too. Oh, yeah. Finally, someone to test my skills. Pepe the Fishmonger? Of course. Shouldn't you be helping? I'll be home as soon as we're done. Okay. So there's a lot of side quests and side missions too as well. Glass blade. Just knock this out, I guess. That's something too to keep in mind of as well, is that because of the stamina feature, basically all your moves, basically all of your moves are available, right, at all times. But the problem with that is that you got to be careful because of your stamina meter. So you can't just like go ham and just do fire blast, or hydro pump, or like whatever it might be, like you do in the normal games or whatever, because or in Pokemon games, I guess, because there's like a little bit more of a strategy like behind all that, right? I'm trying to see if there's anything over here. It doesn't look like it. I can't change the camera angle as well, by the way. Just FYI. So. Keep that in mind. These are pretty strong, actually. Ah. Tenderness. What does this do again? I'll lower his attack, right? So I think depending on what type of game you want out of Temtem, it could be really good. I haven't really looked that much stuff into it. I played like an hour or two, or like an hour of the stress test, so I'm definitely trying to see how good of a game it is, to be honest. It's really debatable for me. I don't mind, per se, like the hardness was... This is a special defense buff. I don't mind the hardness with the game, but as you can see, like, we're already... This is the first route, and you're already kind of, like, not getting owned, per se, but you're going to come across trainers that are pretty good. You know, the logic is, well, you're just new, right? You're a newbie trainer or whatever, and you don't have good Temtem, so... train what? Great fit. Sounds interesting. Very good for you two. For instance, have you tried jumping over ledges? Run, jump. You never move. Wow. You can jump over. Okay, dude. Just debated me. Hey, this is supposed to be my spot. You come to pick all that sweet stuff lying around? Let me tell you. Let's fight. Okay. So, in my opinion, you know, one of the things that the game is trying to force you to do, which, once again, I don't mind that much, but can be kind of annoying, is the game is trying to force you to use different Temtems. You know, it's your Temtems will get knocked out, your Temtems will die, and I'm gonna use both. It's double tech, pretty good. I should have used that first then, if I knew that. But it is trying to force you to use multiple Temtems, right? It's like it doesn't want you to just use like just two, or just like, you know, keep like a couple of them or whatever. So these are like boxes that you can open, loot boxes. Got an apple, just more grass down here, and then this brings us back to here. I'm gonna go heal up because I'm lazy and I don't like spending items. We'll have to see what the prices are when we get there, but halfway through this route is a Mm-hmm. Sorry, daughter was asking me a question about some stuff. Yeah, but so, one of the things that I noticed is that healing potions are really, really expensive in this game. And we'll get to that in a sec here, after we get through this little area of the route. But from what I recall, a Temtem card, which is essentially what a Pokeball is in this game, is roughly like 80 gold. And a potion in this game was something like 300. So it was super, super expensive comparatively. Let's go get this thing over here that we saw earlier. There we go. Got a revive, which is nice. Okay, so we have to go through this grass, which is fine. Good morning, hunting for Temtem. Sure, good hunting. Can we fight her? Oh, I should have asked to fight. More grass over here. We have this rock face here. Let's climb in no time if we had proper air. So this is like for later. It's like rock climb or something. No, sorry. Yeah, I didn't have much hope. Rock climbing gear is probably what we need. Okay. That's probably like, I don't think they're like HMs, but they're like special abilities that you get later in the game. To be able to like climb stuff and traverse stuff. This is a boss bat. This is a trainer fight right here. I am Lauren. Together we are the lethal twins. That's right, Lauren. I'm sorry. That's what I said. No, you mean I. Anyway, prepare to battle. Whatever. Let's fight. So I do find it interesting that you can skip trainer battles if you choose so. I guess depending on if you feel like you're weak or something like that, you are able to like pass them up or whatever. So I thought that was kind of interesting. Shy shield. Is that going to increase? What is that going to increase? Increase defense. Bubbles. It's going to increase my speed. We didn't need to use it, but we're fine. I do like the stamina feature in the game, though. It makes like an extra little depth or whatever. Like, I don't have to really care about PP or like having to like deal with those or whatever in the game. Ooh, they have two more Pokemon, though. Or Temtems. I keep calling them Pokemon. It's really easy to be honest. We don't have enough. So I'm gonna wait, actually. My Pokemon are my Temtems are basically at full, right? Oh wow, he rested as well. That's interesting. I wonder if it will hit, because it's a double. It still will hit. That's cool. That's pretty cool, actually. Just killed itself. So basically, it like cuts its stamina in half so that it doesn't get hurt, basically. I get it. Oh, wait, how did you do it? We got a new strategy. Lacera. Ah, yeah. So there's these guys, and then this right here is kind of like a rest stop area. Hey, you, come fight us. So some of them are not skippable. Some of them, I guess, you have the option of being able to skip. Well. This is like a debuff. Lowers our attack, I believe, right? Or is it defense? Defense. Okay, so that's kind of like Tail Whip. Water Blade. Oh wow, that hit for a lot. Yeah, we have a thing. My speed's gonna go up though from that, so that's good. I'm gonna use Glass Blade on this, and then I'll use Shrill Voice on both of them. We go for the double knockout right here. Oh yes, nice. Get your own. There's a Pokemon Center right here, boys. Hey, Shigos, it took you a while. Just kidding, how are you? Who are you? I work at the Temporium. And I'm a friend of the professor. He had to hurry, head down, but asked me to check on you kids. Please heal my Temtem. Sorry, it's my day out, but don't worry. See that little solver? That's the mini Temporium. Town's up proper Temporium buildings. We can have mini ones, strategic places. You can heal them. You can also organize your stuff or buy stuff. Okay. So this is the Pokemon Center, basically. Or, like, rest stops, I guess you could say. Go there. I guess this one, you can deposit your Temtems here if you don't want to use them, which I'm going to do. All right. Bye. All right. So I'm covering it up with my camera here, but it is 80 for a bomb and 60 for a revive, or not a revive. Sorry, this is like a... This is like a... What is it? I forgot what they're called in Pokemon, but they're the things that make it so you don't have to encounter things. And then these are your, like, Pokeballs, basically. So these are pretty cheap, actually. I'm going to buy a couple more of these, just in case. But yeah, so they're quite expensive comparatively to everything else. Potions are, like, super expensive, where I believe in Pokemon it's the opposite. So I'm actually going to search through here really quick, because I want to see if there's any more Pokemon or Temtems I can encounter. If I've missed anything. Like this. I have no clue what this is, but it looks cool. So I'm going to attack with one. That should be good. Should be able to capture it. Temp card. I thought this was interesting that you can use two temp cards technically and just see if you capture it. If you fail, you can try again. So you do get, like, two chances with this or whatever. I'll send it. The squad. We can check it right now. You know, it does come how it is. It's a grass one. It has shyness, shield, and tenderness. These are both buffing things. So it's kind of like a cocoon type Pokemon or Temtem. I gotta stop saying Pokemon. I'm just so used to it. But yeah, it's like a cocoon. Ooh, this looks interesting. Try to knock that one out. So at least we don't have to worry about the Swally, because it's a... it's whatever. Ah, poison. So poison and effects, it tells you right here, they will always last a certain amount of turns. Outside of battle, they will last X amount of steps. So I think it's like 5 steps and they do damage still or whatever outside of battle. So those are pretty annoying as well. Use the time card on that duder. Hopefully we catch it. Nice, we got it. Kaku. Nature Temtem. Caffeinated trait. Prevents its sleeping conditions. Okay. And then it's still gonna get hit with the poison even after you knock out stuff, which I find pretty interesting. That's a pretty interesting little thing. Let's go heal this guy up and then check him out. Let's see here. Check the squad really quick. So it just knows the toxic spores in the shield right now. See, this is the problem. Like, I get why Pokemon does things like experience share, because I want to use this Temtem, but at the same time I don't, because it only knows like a poison ability, which is kind of annoying, you know? But yeah, let's switch this out. So, hold on. I'm gonna do that really quick. And then I want to put this one in here for now. It is so nice to play this on keyboard and mouse, though, at a time. Yeah, it's a long way. So... Okay, this is like a stamina thing. My thing might get knocked out here, so... See how this goes. I want to get rid of this as fast as possible, to be honest. Ooh, wow. That did a lot of damage. Of course it goes on my guy. My strongest guy. Won't die. We have a gym, at least, like, close. Damn. Or a Pokemon Center, I mean. It's gonna die right now, unfortunately, but it got the hidden, so I'm happy. Wow. Wow. I didn't learn anything new! Darn it. Alright, we got the Birdo. Genki. This thing looks cool. It's like an electric bug or something. Has to rest, unfortunately. Half damage, okay. Sparks, what does this do? It's a buff, it seems, okay. Special attack is up, alright. Just raising its special attack, which is kind of scary. Poison that. It looks like poison doesn't do anything in the sense. Oh, wait, hold on. Can we go back? We gotta escape. It's gonna take up all its stuff, so. Oh, wow. Okay, so we should have just knocked out this. I was like, maybe it's gonna attack now, but maybe that's all it knows right now, which is kind of weird. Hopefully the poison just kills it at this point. Yeah, it seems to only know that ability right now, so we're fine for now. And then hopefully the poison kills it. Got it. A rigorous training. See, oh my gosh, this 10 times useless. The useless. That would be way more helpful than that. Okay, we'll just go back here then. No, Temtem has like really interested me so far. So, is there a way to get? Is there like a quick button for squad? I don't even know. Let's just keep these two deers then for the time being. We can find one of those electric bugs. That actually looks pretty interesting to use. I think that's a deer right there. It's down here. It's like a little grass patch. Kind of weird that you have to run around for so long to encounter wild sometimes. It's very interesting to me. Ooh, this thing, a scale. Skull. Scale? Level 5 too, that's pretty good. I don't think this will kill it. There we go. That's definitely gonna get in at least. And neutral though. I don't know if I want. Send a squad. We might use it actually. Roam this grass too. These did like literally nothing, right? So let's switch this out then. I hope they didn't do anything. Pretty sure they didn't do anything, but I feel like sometimes too, one of the things I have issues with is that battles seem to take a little bit. The animations and stuff are kind of cool, but I wish I could speed them up a bit. One of the things I've noticed as well with this game is that you seem to get way less XP, and I mean like a significant amount of less XP when it comes to wild battles versus normal battles. I've noticed that like almost instantly with this game, so I don't know how I feel about that. I get what it's trying to do, but I don't know if that is something that I'm okay with or not. Because that means that farming is going to be like really, really dumb. What does this do? So it's it has a bonus because I'm with another Temtem, I guess. Like it uses Crystal Dust. That Temtem, that bird, powers it up. So like having certain Temtems together is really vital, I guess you could say, and really like helps out or whatever. Yeah, so synergies. Techniques can be boosted if the partner is a specific type, right? So because it's like a winged Temtem or whatever, it boosts them a lot. So I can see why people are comboing these two together now. Now that like I kind of understand that or whatever. What the heck? Do that and hopefully this kills it. It's level 3, so I wouldn't see why it wouldn't. Okay, so the squad, we have Crystal, and then the next person that we have, don't have any gear in your backpack. Okay. We have Crystal and we have Wind. So I guess Crystal and Wind power up each other. That's something good to kind of know or whatever for future. Work in progress. Interesting. So another thing that I've noticed about this game too as well is that so that center for healing is basically the closest center that there is until we get to the next town. And to basically go back to that center every time we need to heal is really annoying. So potions are like really, really essential to this game. Which I think to having to go back there every single time is really annoying. Let's see if this one hits. Doesn't. But I think even the peck at half or the wind blade at half will kill it. I'm hoping. This is just like doing defensive stuff, so we don't really need to worry about those anymore. I believe this card here too means that you own it. There is like a capture indicator. Hey, level 10. Wow. Crazy. Actually looks like it's gonna be really strong. The stamina for that though looks pretty insane. All right, let's open this. Let us open this. Check it out. We found two ethers. It's like the PP up, whatever you want to call them or whatever. I was going to talk to this person. Oh, this is a trainer. Okay. Here for a little Temtem balance, just what I need. So he has one Pokemon. It's probably really strong. Or Temtem. It's probably really, really strong though, I'm assuming. Level 8, yeah. So we'll use Crystal Dust on this. I want to try. I just want to see what this move does. I know it says that it's not going to do a lot of damage, but I'm just curious to see what it is or how it looks. Ah, that was invigorating. All right. I don't know where any of these Temtems are located, by the way, like when it comes to grass or whatever. So I'm kind of just wandering around to see where they are. Now, if I were to switch out for Skull, I want to see if both Temtems got XP or not. I'm assuming that they would. They do, yeah. So these give incredibly a less amount of XP, by the way. Like, that's crazy. So I want to switch out... Let's do this for now. Let's do this for now and see what happens. I'm just curious to see how strong this dude is on his own. I want to encounter some more wild battles, though. Just to see if there's anything out in this brush that we've missed. I'm kind of a collector, so I like to go around and continually see what there's available. Sand Splatter. Okay, so this does half damage to all this stuff. So we should probably strike this. And bleed that. You can probably echo both of them to get it down like really, really fast too. Scratch, drill voice, double attack both of them. Nice. Got them both down, chat. Got them both down. Let's keep moving on. Let's do, let's try and check out one more counter. I feel like boss, like, battles just take so long sometimes here. This is a trainer for sure. You, let's fight now. You say please, no, fight. Alright, well, try to be nice. Oh, he has two of those Sparky boys. I want. Okay. Quarter damage. It didn't tell me that it didn't do a quarter damage, though. That's kind of annoying. Oh, wow. It actually knows stuff. Actually... And then easy. Failed. Suck. Bam. Getting it up levels actually doesn't seem too bad. I think if you have another Tem that can carry it, then you should be fine. Oh, that was just a player. That's funny. This is not a player, though, I'm assuming. I can't go down this way, so. Boom. Are you... Ah, you look like a Temtem trainer, but how well do you actually know your Temtem? Of course I knew. What are they effective against? I'm assuming fire. Grass or nature, yep. Anyway, enough theory. Let's go. Okay. Okay. Now that you know, let me kick your butt! Wow, level 11. Jeez. See, it doesn't say that it was weak against it, but some of them it does. It's really weird. Okay. Okay, luckily I hit my other one. There we go. Okay. About all, you're getting the hang of it. Thanks. Yeah, so this game definitely seems like something that I feel like I would have to grind off stream, possibly, which isn't necessarily like a bad thing, I would say, but it's over here. So there's really nothing over here. I'm guessing there's, I'm just looking for like hidden items and stuff. Unfortunately, there's nothing here. There's a double battle here. There's a solo battle here. What's the solo play? I mean, it's not. Oh, wait, this is where I came from. I'm an idiot. Oh, let's use items too then. Inventory. Let's just use a bomb. Okay. See if there's anything in. We should probably. Oh, okay. Well, I was going to say, we should probably go to the town first before we check this stuff, but. Let's kill this really quick. Damn. We got the double battle here. Look, Mom, another tamer. Let's have a battle. Wait a second, little one. We should introduce ourselves. I'm Yota, and this is my daughter. I'm Shigos. Hi, Shigos. Which way is Bristle? Bristle is just north. Can we play now? Let's play. Okay, so we have to keep going. Oh, interesting. Same Pokemon. Or Temtem. Bristle and Schnauzer. Schnauzer. Let's get rid of the stronger one first then, yeah? Shall we? Let's see what this does to its typing. Okay, half damage is pretty good. Probably knock it out right now. Half damage, come on. Imble. Is it speed? Okay. Oh, toxic spores, that's annoying. Crystal. Dust on that. Let's do shrill voice, doesn't really matter. I should have probably done it on that one so we could have gotten the double knockout, actually. Ugh, both poisoned now. It's gonna defense up. Okay, nice. But they're still poisoned, so they're gonna take some damage after the battle. Or at least Crystal will. Well, you're very good. Be fit and strong. So there's a little flash for that. I'm assuming this is a trainer as well. We're fine on health and stuff, so it should be good. Have you met? No. Figures, I never forget a face. In my case, I'm happy to meet new people. Okay. Wow. Wow. Very strong. Okay, debuff. Defense is lowered, hopefully. Oh, double stare. Interesting. What are they going to put it on? Oh, both of them. Okay. Well, defense is lowered on both. All right. That's fine. Ooh. Wow. That hurt. It's gonna hurt itself, but I want to just kill this. Does that? I want to see if also stamina. I'm probably does, but does stamina affect? Yeah, it does. Dang. I was hoping it didn't, but. Maybe I can help. What do you know about Tundra? You can't really help unless you're a proper tamer, but I am. Okay, then. So, Zemina, well, so everything was working until this ridiculous, but anyway, she really loves wind Temtem. Me, I'm more of a water Temtem sort of girl. So, you don't understand. It's personal. Water and wind don't go well together. Perhaps we're just not made for each other. Anyway, so this has escalated, and now we're not. I know. Oh, okay. Oops. Perhaps another day. Interesting. Nope, she doesn't want to fight. Okay. Well. Oh, is this the next town? Sick. We made it. She's the dojo master of Aerosol. Hi kids, how are you? I'll be giving you a little tour of Brickle Daymar before I drop you off. Kids, this is where we part. My airship sails an hour, so I have to rush. I leave you in the capable hands of Sophia. Oh, get out of here. Yeah. We're at the next town. Follow me, friends, alright? This little shop is, it stock all sorts of knickknacks for tourists. It's a good place to get your first Temsin bile. So save up and get it as soon as you can afford it. Okay, this way now, okay? Indigo Lake always feels Sundays when this is too crowded. I come here to surf a bit and train my water Temtem. Okay. This big building is it's managed by an associate. That's where I'm going, to the dojo. One day, Max, when you're ready. For now, all new apprentices come here to learn the basics. Once you're properly trained, you might join my dojo. No buts. But, I mean, this way is a Temporium. So this is like the Pokemon Center, I guess, or the whatever healing place that you want to go. So it's our local Temporium. Okay. Interesting. We have to go to the Okay. So we have to go and do all that good stuff. Okay, so let's talk around. Hi Dad, are you the new babysitter? No, I see there's why is everyone over here? Where did you get it? Oh, Dad got it from me. Oh, cool. But I would love a real Pigga pick. Here, Hammer, can you bring me a Pigga pick, pretty please? Sure, I'll find one. Okay. Pigga pick. Do I have that? I'm not sure. Let's go see. This is the center. Oh, there's like multiple ones. I don't have one. Do I even know what that looks like in my Tempedia? Ori, Paru, Boma, Skull, Yuki, Crystal, Genki. So I don't even have like the information. Yes. Okay, thanks. Okay. I don't even have that then. You can't search, huh? Pig up. Oh, this thing. I don't even have one of my own, lady. Okay. Oh, you know what? We should check the shop. Okay, so it's basically just a bunch of other stuff so we can get antidotes and stuff like that. Hold on. Well, that other person, so we should go purchase, acquire a vial of essence or whatever. So let's go check to see how much that costs, I guess. First, Let's look. I'm just gonna go through everything though. Hold on. Would you like a postcard? Another thing, okay? Something to remind you of your amazing vacation? No, thanks. Oh, I see. Actually, you do look... Oh, wait. I know you're... Okay. Sure, I think... Let me check. Here it is. No serious temperature can go... It's potent, so comes in time. One dose is enough to heal your whole soul. But hey, I hate to charge your family, so let's do something else instead. I'm happy to give you 4 file if you're serious about your temcrum. I am. And I don't know, but I need some proof of some kind of food. You came from Zadar. You must have caught a wild temtem. That's the minimum I keep. Bring me a temtem from... the coast. Any apprentice worth the saint in the name would do such thing. I have Scully, that's great, but keep it under control. It could wreck my shop. Oh, okay. That's actually really useful then. So a vial of temessence, enough to heal your whole squad. Oh, okay. So you can use it, it's like a one time use, but then it. Okay, that's pretty cool. And then we have to bring a pig, which we can't do right now because I have no clue where to get those. Talk to you, lady. Interesting. Jesus, there's so many people in these places. I wonder what kids are doing now. They're just invading your house. Is what everyone's doing in this whole town. Just FYI. Why would you think so? Yeah, I'm not from there, unfortunately. Oh, I wanted to go back here and check to see, because she's mentioned a surfboard. Do you have a surfboard? I'm sorry, I saw the last one yesterday, and a very cool board with Sophia bought it. I'm supposed to get more stuff next if you don't mind waiting. Thanks, see you later. Okay. So basically, no, you can't have one right now. Yes. Okay. Jeez, there's so many NPCs to talk to. Holy crap. Hello there. Have you come to call the what? Although it's the cute. Oh. So what do you do? I'm studying the river. Ah. Non-swimmer. Okay, chill. If I go up, can I buy a pig here? What the heck is that thing? I wanted to see if we can get a pig from here, maybe? There's like any new wild temtem here? I'm gonna switch out. Just so we can, like, farm some XP for a bit, maybe. See how that goes. Wow. Why did it get hit so much? I wish there was like a feedback thing. Got hit so hard. Actually so hard. Seems like these are the only things that are here. Sand splatter. Level 4 dance game. Plus XP. Actually, let's see what happens if I scratch. See what that does damage wise. Yeah, you don't get much XP ever. Yeah. Can you climb up this ladder? No, you can't. Eh, I tried. You're not all new kids at the company, but it assumes. Oh. See you in class, okay. Your locker. Again. Redemption says you can't copy a combination. Let me think. So, oh gosh, so I'm on a fetch quest now. That's what this game's brought me to. Oh, wrong place. This person, maybe? I'm Oh my god. Oh, okay. Okay. Now we need to go back here. Oh my gosh. Okay, so further your training at the dojo. Okay. We're about to start today, so please open your master, your Temtem statistics. What? Do I actually have to sit down and, like, learn this? I'm so confused. Do I actually have to sit here and do this class? Happens if I go upstairs. Okay. To go get a surfboard. See you later. Okay, so just do the map then, I guess. Okay, this map's useless. I can already tell. But I just have to, like, go around, like, all the... These are the old people, right? So there won't be in here. Anything over here? The dialogue is so weird. It's just like, yeah, okay. All right, peace, bye. At the beach, then? Interesting. It's like all side quests. I feel like I'm going way out of the way for no reason, but... Interesting. So the ship doesn't exist anymore, basically. Okay, good to know. Yeah, I have no clue where these people are. Alright. Though, I should get going right now. I know it was like a super short stream, guys, but I have a massive headache. So I think I'm going to end it here. I'll be on tomorrow, possibly in the morning, and I will be on tomorrow night for sure for some more Temtem and stuff like that to check it out. So, thanks for hanging out, guys. Thanks for lurking and chilling as always and all that good stuff. I don't know why, but I have a massive headache, like a splitting headache. So I'm going to go, but thanks for hanging out. Thanks for chilling and all that good stuff. And yeah, I'll most likely see you guys later. Like I said, we'll be on tomorrow during the evening, 100%, and then possibly during the night as well, or in the morning as well. If you guys want to follow me, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, all that good stuff as well. If you guys want to follow the channel, you can always do so. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Have a great rest of your night, and hope you guys enjoyed Temtem. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.